Okay, good morning. Assalamu alaikum. I hope you all are doing well. And I hope that we all make sense of whatever we are doing. So let's start with our next thing, whatever we are reading. Today we are going to talk about implicatures and Grice's theory of conversational implicature into this. If you remember in the last class, I asked you people to read about implicature, what is implicature, and then we'll talk about it. So today we are going to talk about what is it. Beta, ye PowerPoint slide is there on your Moodle. I'll try to email you this as well. I'll try if I can email this video. Otherwise, I'll upload that on Moodle. I'll ask you people to see what works. So abhi is week mein, maybe we have a bit of ups and downs with the technology. It is perfectly fine. Don't worry. I'll make sure that you get the things that you have to, and you get whatever you whatever is necessary for you, right? So the thing is that number one, don't panic, especially for this, for my course. I'll be there. You know, I'll not have anything that you will not be able to understand. I just want one thing, and that is your response. Please, mujhe respond karte rehna beta, taki mujhe pata chale ki aapko ye baat samajh aa rahi hai, nahi aa rahi hai, aapko kya issues hai. Unless and until you let me know ki ye online classes aur in cheezon mein kya issues aa rahe hai, I'll not be able to resolve them. Okay, so let's start with implicatures. What is an implicature? Normally, it is defined as the implied meaning. Jo listener meaning extract karta hai, imply karta hai, out of the conversation. And remember, we talk about when we talk about pragmatics, we learned that there are so many things that are involved jo background mein hoti hain, jinki wajah se hum kuch cheeze imply kar rahe hote hain. So the term implicature accounts for what a speaker can imply, suggest or mean as distant from what the speaker literally says. So sometimes the words are different, but the meaning is different. And that is where implicature comes in pragmatics. Remember, pragmatics is about the study of the written discourse. It's not the study of the written discourse. It's only about the oral thing. So speaker jo kehta hai, literally jo uske words hote hain, wo mukhtalif ho sakte hain as compared to the meaning that is there. So the speaker imply that meaning, he or she extract that suggested meaning out of that. So implicature is one of the ways that says that one proposition can be conveyed by a speaker uttering or under appropriate circumstances. So let's have an example. Alan says, are you going to Paul's party? And Bob says, I have to work. So, agar hum semantically dekhein, pragmatically nahi, semantically words, syntax is structure, semantics is meaning. Agar hum iska meaning dekhein, toh Alan is saying, are you going to Paul's party? And the answer, I have to work, is not at all in relevance to the question. But then, if we look at the pragmatic, in the pragmatic sense, yes, it makes sense. How? Because if this was a typical exchange, Bob meant that she's not going to Paul's party by saying that she has to work. She did not say that she's not going to Paul's party. And the sentence she uttered does not mean that. But the sentence she uttered does not mean that semantically, but it meant that pragmatically, right? So let's see. This is implicature, and implicatures come in conversation, and we call them conversational implicatures as well. Okay, let's see. Grice introduced the technical terms implicit and implicature for the case in which what the speaker said is distant from what the speaker thereby meant or implied. Abhi jaise humne pichle example mein dekha, what was said was different than what she or he meant to say. So in the next example, let's see, this is a situation where Carla is a dispatcher in a city of Denver where it is sunny and dry. But Don is a truck driver and he's trying to get over the continental divide during a blizzard. There is a blizzard at the other part of the world jahan pe unhone cheezein dispatch karni and deliver karni hai. So Carla asked him, how's the weather over there? And Don says, the weather is lovely. Now, Don is using irony. He said that the weather is lovely, but he thereby meant that the weather is terrible. So he implicated that the weather is terrible. The thing is that they are एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस बिकॉज बेटे उनका कॉन्टेक्स्ट सेम है. दे आर लिविंग, इफ समथिंग इज सेड टू मी और टू यू उसका कॉन्टेक्स्ट डिफरेंट होगा, राइट. अभी जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ओके आई आस्क यू हाउ आर यू पीपल एंड यू से मैम वी आर फाइन एंड आई से ओके स्टे सेफ and it's a full stop. So this stay safe has a context in this COVID-19 situation. So that's where implied meanings come in. That's where we understand whatever we are saying. So I want to say that implications are more than what is said. It is what the speaker means. And how do we understand this? We understand this with the help of context. इसमें पूरी सिंपल इसमें प्रगमैटिक्स जो है वो आती है. जैसे हमने पहले पढ़ा था कि प्रगमैटिक्स जो है वो इट इज़ अबाउट बिटवीन द स्पीकर एंड द लिसनर. सो सेम इज़ द केस विद implicatures. Implicature इज वन ऑफ द वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट, वन ऑफ द वेरी क्रूशल कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन प्रगमैटिक्स, ठीक है. सो दिस इज व्हाट इम्प्लीकेचर इज. अच्छा, इम्प्लीकेचर के साथ ही आगे हमारे पास ग्राइसिस के मैक्सिम्स आते हैं. आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट ग्राइसिस मैक्सिम्स इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. फॉर दिस इम्प्लीकेचर वीडियो दैट्स इट, दैट्स व्हाट इम्प्लीकेचर इज. हम आगे देखते हैं कि ग्राइस ने implicature पे और these are actually called conversational implicatures because we converse and we find out the meaning. So let's see कि ग्राइस ने conversational implicature पे क्या theory दी है and how does that goes into pragmatic thing.